also known as St Bernadette of Lourdes, was born in Lourdes, France, on January 7, 1844. Her parents were very poor. She was baptized at St Pierre's, the local parish church, on January 9. As a toddler, Bernadette contracted cholera and suffered extreme asthma. Unfortunately, she lived the rest of her life in poor health. On Thursday, February 11, 1858, 14-year-old Bernadette was sent with her younger sister and a friend to gather firewood when a very beautiful lady appeared to her above a rose bush in a grotto called Misabiella. This was the first apparition. The woman wore blue and white and smiled at Bernadette before making the sign of the cross with a rosary of ivory and gold. Bernadette fell to her knees, took out her own rosary and began to pray. Bernadette later described the woman as a small young lady. Though her sister and her friend claimed they were unable to see her, Bernadette knew what she saw was real. 3 days later, Bernadette, her sister and other girls returned to the grotto, where Bernadette immediately knelt, saying she could see Aquero again. On February 18, Bernadette said the vision asked her to return to the grotto each day for a fortnight. With each visit, Bernadette saw the Virgin Mary, and the period of daily visions became known as the Holy Fortnight. When Bernadette began to visit the grotto, her parents were embarrassed and attempted to stop her but were unable to do so. On February 25th, Bernadette claimed to have had a life-changing vision. The vision had told her to drink of the water of the spring, to wash in it and to eat the herb that grew there as an act of penance. The next day, the grotto's muddy waters had been cleared and fresh clear water flowed. On March 2nd, at the 13th of the apparitions, Bernadette told her family, the lady said, a chapel should be built and a procession formed. Her 16th vision, which Bernadette claimed to have experienced for over an hour, was on March 25. Bernadette claimed she had asked the woman her name, but her question was only met with a smile. Bernadette asked again, three more times, and finally the woman said, I am the Immaculate Conception. Though many townspeople believed she had indeed been seeing the Holy Virgin, Bernadette's story created a division in her town. Many believed she was telling the truth, while others believed she had a mental illness and demanded she be put in a mental asylum. Some believed Bernadette's vision meant she needed to pray for penance. Since Bernadette first caused the spring to produce clear water, 69 cures have been verified by the Lourdes Medical Bureau. Bernadette believed it was faith and prayer that was responsible for curing the sick. Bernadette asked the local priest to build a chapel at the site of her visions, and this sanctuary of Our Lady of Lourdes is now one of the major Catholic pilgrimage sites in the world. Following the miracles and constructions, Bernadette decided she did not like the attention she was getting and went to the hospice school run by the Sisters of Charity of Nevers, where she was taught to read and write. Though she considered joining the Carmelites, her health was too fragile. On July 29, 1866, Bernadette took the religious habit of a postulant and joined the Sisters of Charity at their mother house at Nevers. The Mother Superior at that time named her Marie Bernadette in honor of her grandmother. Bernadette spent the rest of her life there working as an infirmary assistant and later a sacristan. People admired her humility and spirit of sacrifice. Unfortunately, she was diagnosed with tuberculosis of the bone in her right knee and was unable to take part in the convent life. She died in the Holy Cross Infirmary of the convent of St. Gilda at the age of 35 on April 16, 1879 while praying the Holy Rosary. Even on her deathbed, Bernadette suffered severe pain, and keeping with the Virgin Mary's admonition of penance, she proclaimed, all this is good for heaven. Bernadette's last words were, Blessed Mary, Mother of God, pray for me, a poor sinner, a poor sinner. 30 years later, on September 22nd, two doctors and a sister of the community exhumed her body. They claimed the crucifix and the rosary she carried had been oxidized, but her body remained incorrupt. The incorruption was cited as one of the miracles supporting her canonization. The church exhumed her body again on April 3rd, 1919, and the doctor who examined her said, the body is practically mummified. In 1925, Bernadette's body was exhumed yet again. This time, relics were sent to Rome. St. Bernadette is often depicted in prayer with a rosary or appealing to the Holy Virgin. She was beatified in 1925 and canonized by Pope Pius XI in December 1933. St. Bernadette is the patroness of illness, people ridiculed for their piety, poverty, shepherds, shepherdesses, and lords.
Holy Trinity, one God,
have mercy on us.
Holy Mary,
pray for us.
Saint John the Baptist,
pray for us.
Saint Peter,
pray for us.
Saint